And I guess he tells them. This is gonna be a franchise, though. They wanted to build on it.
Yeah.
There we go. That's the end of Gravity Circuit, I guess.
Yep. So I bought this game on a whim a while back. Also, there's the name, by the way, Dominic Minmark. So for those of you who are familiar with the name Next Corrupted, the music and character design is where a lot of his core place is. But anyways, yeah, I bought this game on a whim. I saw a video of this game a while back on YouTube talking about this game. And it is kind of crazy to see how 2023 has been in terms of gaming. Because that was probably one of the best years we had in gaming for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
So games like this would also get swept under the rug. And I decided to pick it up because as a big Mega Man guy, I decided, you know, anything Mega Man-like, I'd try it out. Because maybe I'll find something to fill the void that Capcom had left behind a while back. Because all they want to do is Resident Evil and Monster Hunter nowadays. But I digress. This game is really fun. This game harkens a little bit more towards Mega Man Zero in the sense that it's less about the running and gunning, and more about running and punching people straight in the face and beating them, and bringing down their neck while beating them up. The story is about as simple affair as most Mega Man games tend to be. This game is also incredibly forgiving for a Mega Man game as well, since it's not nearly as brutal with instant death hazards or anything of that nature, but the bosses themselves are still incredibly painful if you don't know what you're doing. The upgrade system I'm a little bit hit and miss on because it does feel like there's a lot of upgrades that are kind of just there in a sense, but then again that's also just because I'm more of the aggressive style of play, so there's that. The color, I do like the palette addition, being able to change your palette, and that also affects your gameplay. And also the game's pretty nice, and unlike Mega Man X6 where you can save people, You don't have to worry about doing anything stupid in the back of that front, so it borrows a lot of ideas from some earlier games that, honestly, it's pretty fun. And I would recommend this game if you haven't picked it up yet, because it definitely fills in the hole that Capcom refuses to fill.
We're missing two armor paints and one burst technique.
I guess we can check that out.
Maybe the armor paint's unlocked now to beat the game. Oh, they have New Game Plus, too!
Yep, there's also New Game Plus mode.
Alright, so you can basically carry everything over. That's cool.
Wow. What are your thoughts about this game?
I mean, I was saying a lot about it. Yeah, I really like it. The fast-paced action, it is nice to see it be a lot more, like, fit about punching instead of, like, just shooting flashes from afar and all that. Oh, there's more database stuff there, too. Welcome back, Master Kai, sir! You can do everything again if you wanted! You're crazy enough to do that. But yeah, I definitely enjoyed a lot of what I saw in this game. It looked very fun. I definitely did feel a lot of like Mega Man Zero vibes from it. Nameless. Oh, that was you, right. Huh. Another character we haven't interacted with, maybe? But yeah, the hookshot thing is a pretty cool mechanic as well. I don't think it helps enhance the platforming be a lot more interesting. But yeah, the basic wall jumps, the punching things, the whole armor system makes have extra upgrades, having the, you know, basically like your ability slots and all that. It really helped you get a lot of Oh geez, you don't have the money for this. Closer look at that rogue fellow. Oh, so you guys gotta interact with somebody for that one. And you gotta complete the compendium for the other one.
Yep. Yeah, may as well take a look and see. Hey, fine.
This guy can't do something for you! Alright, buddy, here you go!
Maybe it's in the arc entrance.
Alright, let's run a simulation, I guess! Sounds like a wonderful idea! Nothing bad will happen at all! Nothing at all! Nothing at all! But yeah, it definitely does have, like, it is nice that it's a little more forgiving in regards to the platforming front. You can feel challenged without feeling like you're just being punished for, like, making one missed jump. Like, all the time. That's something that always sucked about some of the old school Mega Man games. Like, there was one platform set you couldn't figure out. Oh, you lost a life. You gotta go all the way back to this part of the stage to get back here. Lost all your lives. So you gotta redo the whole fucking level again. And it's just one segment that continues to be a bother. It just gets obnoxious. So not having it to death thing is definitely nice. And combat overall just looks fun. Like, getting some of the physical beatdown combos just looks... It does look like a great time when you can actually get used to it. And, well, yeah, the best way to really damage some of these bosses skills, but if you got time trials, you really want to try to up the replay value, trying to improve your skills more and more. Yeah, it's very experimental. That's something a lot of these hardcore, like, platforming indie games would be good with. They, like, fine-tune mechanics, they expect you to, like, really master them.
Yeah, they're really more emphasizing the... I guess it's a bottom... I'm trying to remember if it was bottom up or top down design. But basically, they focus on the game and then build everything around it.
Yeah, I think it's bottom down. I think... But it's bottom up. I think,
bottom up, yeah.
I think top down is basically like... You have like the world built, basically like what the setting is.
Yeah.
And then you build the game around it later. Like what a lot of Western developers do.
And I personally prefer the latter.
Bottom up, yep. Basically come with the game concept and then...
No, the former.
Yeah. Yeah, bottom up, where they basically build a game idea. Basically have like a whole bunch of mechanics figuring out how they want the game to play. Then they craft a world and setting around it as they finish up how the game would work. Like you say all the time, what point is to a story if the game's not fun?
Because by that argument, I can just say, well, your story's great, I can just look it up online. So why would I need to bother buying the game then?
Yeah. A lot of movie visual novel things can be kind of one-dimensional in that regard. But, well, it's nice having a game that really focuses on its gameplay. Reminds you how fun some of the old-school games was, but with some of the modern polish that makes it not as frustrating as old-school games used to be.
Yeah. Like, this is the best of both the old-school and the new-school in my regard.
Yep. It's nice that we have people that are fans of these older, of the older games and wanted to make ROM hack the road. And, well, unlike some developers that basically just decide to go continue their fan project and some try to make money off it, at least some have the sense to make a new IP that goes around with similar ideas. And it's definitely an example of that going very well.
There's another thing that some people levy criticism at towards the indie scene is that, you know, oh, most of it's just the 8-bit or 16-bit or whatever.
They don't have a lot of funds, man. And hell, they go over a lot of the new game of style that they always like playing, I guess, and were inspired by.
Yeah. I mean, this is just something I've heard about, something that's levied at some people, but I can understand it from a certain extent because this sort of game can feel like a dime a dozen. So for it to stand out, it takes a lot more effort. But when I say it like that, that really does speak to the volumes of this game because it is able to stand out, because in spite of it all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because there have been a lot of 8 and 16-bit indie games.
Yeah.
It can feel kind of hard for them to differentiate themselves. So
it's
many
feel similar. Kind of,
Even the hand-drawn aesthetic thing is starting to feel overdone in some ways.
I think the one that... I don't mind the hand-drawn aesthetic thing. The one that I really hate is the 50 Shades of Realism now, because even though that's more of a AAA thing, it's still something I noticed and wanted to bring up because eventually it's starting to become less impressive.
Yeah.
It's like, here, we have realism.
Woo. Their environments will look the fucking same. Like, it's supposed to be realistic, but it ends up not being, like, I don't know. Having some nice caramel visual flair definitely helps.
And I do think Kai's design also looks really cool.
Yeah, I do
all
like
the robot designs.
A lot of the character designs are great in this game. It definitely feels a lot like Zero, and it feels like a little bit like a ninja, too. The way he moves feels like a ninja to me.
I can see it.
The robot ninja. But, yeah, If they do a sequel to this or have another game follow-up, the best game games. It's definitely another developer to keep an eye on. So.
Yeah. Hopefully there's something cool. Hopefully something comes out of this. I'm only bringing this game up as well because this one definitely fell under the radar. And it just kind of felt like a game that just sort of resonated with me. And also, I don't do much indie games for my channel, despite being a pretty avid fan of them. So I figured this might at least fill that void or whatever. Or give you an idea of where my headspace usually goes to when it comes to the indie scene.
Right. I've only done a few myself. And like half the ones I've done have all focused on one fucking franchise.
Yeah.
So.
The only one I've done is the Curse of the Moon.
Yeah.
The first one.
Yeah.
So, it's nice to see get an indie game from Long.
Yeah, show how far and creative this the indie scene can be.
Maybe next time, if I ever come back to the indie scene, there's actually a game I do want to consider a game to work on as well.
I think I know what that is, and I think I have it on my Wii U.
I don't think you do.
Not Freedom Planet?
No.
Oh! That was my guess.
I'll give you a hint. The Ninja Gaiden inspired game.
That I do not have.
I guess we could also go to Freedom Planet as well, since we can't really get free experience in that game. And the one sucky thing is that having a PC is that I don't really have the easiest way of recording stuff.
You just have to practice with equipment, and it is kind of awkward. It would also be taxing your PC.
Yeah. I mean, my PC can probably handle it. It's just I don't have the best setup in terms of internet.
Oh, right.
That's really the biggest thing about my PC that I have a little more problem with.
Well, I guess it only, for the internet, it only depends on the game you're playing if it's really going to be like that.
Yeah.
I've had to try to learn to freaking be, to make use of my resources enough, but a bunch of other things run while I'm trying to be recording and stuff.
Yeah.
It's always the freaking antivirus program, it's always one to do something, it always screws me up. Yeah, the friggin' indie scene has a lot of great games, and people should know that by now.
People deserve to know it.
Yeah.
I think is what it is. Because the thing about the indie scene is that it usually feels more like the hardcore crowd knows about them.
Yeah. It tends to be the lower budget games, too. Like.
Yeah. It's kind of also the proof that you don't need to spend an exorbitant amount of money for one game in particular. Or put all your eggs in one basket.
Yep.
You can just run on slightly less of ridiculous budgets and actually make a good game that profits.
Yeah. The other good thing about indie developers is they don't usually have an answer to a publisher that basically wants to shape the game the way they want to.
Yeah.
Potentially just do it for making money. You know? They just put their passion into it and hope that the fans that enjoy their games will give them the profit they can make to freaking want to make more games.
Yep.
But yeah, they're usually just a very pleasant experience.
Also, another thing. This is free now after you beat the game.
Oh, that's nice. So basically, just let you do all these.
You can do whatever you want, basically. You're free to just do whatever you want.
Oh, that is nice. I'm trying to see where all the other talents are. I do see one of the ultimate blend.
Okay,
oh god.
So where are they?
Oh, beat 13 battles in the combat memory bank.
Ah.
Or one of the two boss gauntlets.
So it is the boss gauntlet stuff upstairs. Alright.
Oh yeah, there was one that showed up in this stage.
Hmm.
Or it shows up at Ark.
Where is it?
There's an entrance where you slide through a pipe. Um It just says location arc. Is that this stage or is that the second one?
Maybe it's the second one, I'll check.
Well, yep, you beat the game for that one to appear. Ow! Oh god! That got a little weird. We have the other ones being the boss gauntlets. Let me see. We can probably get to the purple one. But. Oh! Okay, that's kind of an ability that you got to see from that boss. That he has. The thing you get from the boss gauntlet basically has the effect of every other palette put together.
Huh. Don't know if I should be happy or.
It is called Ultimate, so.
Don't know if I should be happy or terrified about that concept. Because that includes freaking using Cable, but then again, it's not like I'm doing that stupid bouncing off enemies thing again.
Yeah, I guess regular arc? Arc entrance. Oh, so it was this stage.
Oh, yeah. We show this one off because,
yeah, the image I have here shows like a pipe.
Oh.
Around one of the lasers. That's probably why you didn't think about it.
Because to be honest, I would have thought it would be where the three chests were.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm like, ah, that's out of the way enough.
Yeah, you would think. Thankfully, people will be right guys for these games pretty fast. It is appreciated.
I guess it's one of the double-edged swords of modern gaming. Everything's available to you. It's just, you know.
I mean, hey, you're really trying to play a game spoiler-free, just ignore the fucking internet if you can.
I mean, some people might be upset about that concept, but, you know, there's more to life than the internet, contrary to what you're saying.
Yeah.
I know it's a shocking concept, and maybe, oh my god, the real world's terrifying, suck it up.
No, you can watch this video, don't worry, you can watch this. Like I said, I always reference that fucking ukulele possible lair thing.
Yep.
It was like, Mom, where did this secret item be? It's on the internet, will figure it out. And that's your fucking hint. Like, fuck you!
When you pull a card like that, that's when I actually feel a little bit
like, more. Like, I get what you're doing. I kind of hate it, but I can't be extremely mad at you because you're kind of proving the point.
Yeah.
Some people find it and then point it out for everybody else to then look up to find out.
I don't know, maybe it's because of shit like that that's just like, eh.
It feels like a very old school gaming group. I hate it, but I do respect it at the same time. They acknowledge the current era of gaming by acknowledging how stupid it is. But they also are part of the problem. So, there's only so much I can take out of that. But remember, there's eventually the segment where you're falling from the lasers that keep trying to shoot you. One of those is a tunnel you can go into. It only opens up once you beat the game, so.
Oh, it only opens up after you beat the game?
Yes.
Huh.
You have to beat the game to unlock it, so. Not like we're gonna get it the first time through.
Okay. That's why I was kind of wondering more than anything else, but I've gotten it before.
Yep. It's in a room that has green platforms, according to the image I saw. Hey, that one would have been really hard to find. I'd rather not just blindly try to find it.
Because I've already beaten the game, it's like, yeah. I've beaten the game, so I don't
really
feel bad.
Just chilling talking about the fun of the indie scene at this point.
Yeah. The thing about the indie scene is that it's a double-edged sword, because sometimes you can get amazing games, sometimes you can get horrible games.
I feel like it happens more often than not with Kickstarter games.
Yeah.
Oh, down there. And to your right, through there.
Oh, in that thing?
Yes, I think so.
Wow. I really wouldn't have thought to go in there. Especially when one of the sliding pipes you can go into is an obstacle.
Yep. See, there it is. Yeah. I was gonna say, I saw that, I was like, oh, the laser coming through there? That's some shit.
Yeah, I wouldn't have thought to look there.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I looked it up, I didn't feel bad. It's like, that would have been really hard to guess.
And honestly, like, this is also the thing of, after I beat a game, I don't feel bad looking up a guide.
Yeah, at that point, it's like, well, if I want to find everything, I struggle to find it, I may as well complete it just for my own sake. I mean, hey, I don't feel bad about having to look it up, but they don't give you, like, an in-game checklist or anything like that.
Yeah, that's also the big thing. It's like, if you're not going to give me an in-game checklist or whatever, especially for, like, some bigger games, where there's, like, a lot of stuff to collect, you're not going to give me an in-game checklist to see if I've collected everything.
Yeah, that can always be annoying.
Older RPGs are kind of the worst for that.
I'll say some platformers have problems with that.
Yeah.
Especially they have to go for a bunch of collectibles that have to be small and blue.
Ugh.
Oh, boy.
I'll never live that down. I haven't played the game. Still, yeah, but I still don't have to like it.
We can do that next! Oh, God. At least do Brothers 3 before you think about going to that one.
What's that? Was you Sonic 4 now? Got it.
Oh, God! Do we Sonic Superstars?
You mean Sonic CD, right? Right?
That's Sonic 2! I'm so confused!
Yeah, but anyways, what are some of our favorite indie games that we've played from the indie scene?
I mean, I'm always a fan of the Shantae series, especially Pirates Curse. That game, like I said before, I can debate that being like an arguable indie game masterpiece. It is very well done.
For me, it would be...
It has the polish to go with it, too, so that really helps. I mean, Way 4 is pretty good at this stuff.
Then again, Way Forward's also been more established. Then again, I suppose that they're also a little bit more, I guess, liberal, I guess is the best way to put it, when it comes to their publishing compared to other publishers, I guess. They're not the most...
They've at least been around. Like, they're an indie company the same way Treasure's an indie game company.
Yeah, I guess when you put it that way, I guess we could say it like that.
Yeah, fucking... So technically, the way Wario World is an indie game. That's a bit of a stretch.
That's a bit of a stretch. Yes, indie publisher Nintendo.
Gunstar Heroes, in a way, is an indie game, if you look at it that way.
I mean, we could also say that about a lot of, like, one-off games from that era, too, so...
Yeah. But yeah, Way Forward's basically like that.
Yeah.
You know, they have their own established IP. And Capcom helped them develop their first one, and then they basically have been on their own since, for the most part.
Yeah, so... I guess I can say...
That series is a good one. Freedom Planet's pretty good.
Especially the second one. I'm a big fan of the second Freedom Planet.
Well, of course, all the Creed games.
Yes.
Well, I guess more so Zerg Striker Gumball onward.
Yeah. I mean, I like Curse of the Moon. Curse of the Moon, I think, is really good.
Yeah. I forgot.
And Ritual of the Night, by extension.
Capcom did... I want to say they might have co-developed the Mega Man Zero games. Or at least helped...
That's NC Creates, you're thinking.
That's right, Matt. What did I say?
Yeah. Yes, Capcom.
Well, I meant the Mega Man Zero games, but... Capcom helped, like... co-develop or at least help publish those games or creates. Is there a story to go, though?
It filled the void that basically Mega Man Zero fans wanted, more in particular.
Yeah. I believe me, you can't hear our friggin' great indie game conversation. I mentioned Hollow Knight, though. You probably hear that one a lot.
I mean, I haven't played Hollow Knight, so I don't really have...
You probably mostly heard of it from me, but believe me, I hear about it all the fucking...
Have you played it at all, out of curiosity?
I played it. I didn't do everything in it, but I played it. And I enjoyed it. I just think it's pretty overrated.
I think it's because I heard it more as like another Dark Souls-style game that I just kind of rolled my eyes.
It's like a Dark Souls Castlevania game. It's good, but it's...
I know you and
sometimes
I...
Sometimes it's frustrating more than it's fun. That's what I think, anyway.
Yeah, for me, I guess I'm also kind of... I guess you and I have differing opinions on this one, but Shovel Knight, for me...
I think it's pretty good.
I think it's because that you've seen too much of it.
Yeah.
That it kind of feels less like an indie game and more like a double A or something.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, they just had a lot of time and passion. That game they worked on for like 6 or 7 years. Like,
I'm not gonna sit here and like, but yeah, I will say Shovel Knight. For as much as maybe it's exhausting to hear about it because it is kind of like the poster boy for the indie scene. I mean,
play number 9.
It deserves a title, Shovel Knight. I think.
Yeah. Shovel Knight was good. Yeah, I got no problem with that. I bought Shovel Knight on Wii U when it was out for like $15.
And I'll buy the game again when I get a Steam sale on GOG. I like it that much. When it comes on sale.
Yeah.
I mean, wouldn't be the first time I bought a game multiple times. Look at me in the Mega Man collection.
Yeah. Well, you did get the 0X collection, right?
Yep.
0DX, yeah.
Damn it.
you technically don't need the X Legacy Collection because you have all the games still. Unless you really want them for some reason.
I have them on Steam.
Well, then again, you can get them for pretty good discounts, like.
Yeah, I got it for a decent price, so
it's not. I think last holiday I saw, like, you get, like, X Legacy Collections 1 and 2 combined for, like, freaking $19,
$20. Yeah, there's usually decent sales for that.
Capcom's usually pretty good at that.
Another indie game that I'm a pretty big fan of in recent memory was, actually two of them by extension.
Oh,
the Messenger.
Messenger and Sea of Stars,
and Sea of Stars. I haven't finished Sea of Stars, but I fucking love where it's going so far. Sea of Stars filling in the gap that, it basically feels like a combination of Golden Sun and, Chrono Trigger.
That does sound very good.
It's amazing, and the Messenger is the answer to all the pretty indie for Ninja Gaiden fans with its own twist, and it's just those two games are amazing. I would highly recommend them easily. And go out of your way if you're a fan of Ninja Gaiden in any way, shape, or form. Like, the twist that the Messenger pulls is one of the best, especially for the indie scene.
Yeah, I have heard nothing but good things about those games.
Yes.
I was gonna say, I thought there was another I had, but. Ukulele! That's very mixed, unfortunately.
And I'm one of the I'm on the side of not liking it that much.
Yeah, it's basically like a very rough Banjo-Kazooie, basically.
Actually, there was another one that I think about that I can bring up, speaking of that. Super Sammy Roll. That game is a crazy, like, 3D platformer. The story's pretty simple, and the gameplay is, there's just three separate mechanics. You just bounce, you jump, and you use your tongue with one of the characters. But the way the levels are structured, it's the craziest 3D platformer that it encourages a lot of speedrunning. It's super replayable, super bite-sized levels. It's great.
Oh, that reminds me. I want to play Neon White one of these days.
I have Neon White. I should get to that.
Apparently, if you're like a fan of first-person shooters, especially fast-paced gameplay, it's like some of the best that the video games have to offer. It's just cringy anime story around it, but otherwise.
Oh, hey, I'm a fan of that stuff, so I can take that.
If you can deal with a cringy anime story, apparently got one of the best first-person video games imaginable.
That sounds amazing, and I want to.
Like, it's a bunch of stage-based, like, speed-running platforming and shooting and stuff.
I'm actually looking up my inventory right now, because I'm a little curious to see what.
Yeah, why not?
Indie list
looks like. Here's the stained purple color you get. It is. Warm purple look allows you to grab blocks off the ground. Grab objects can be purged to power up next burst technique. Mysterious latent powers.
Ah.
So you pull blocks out of the ground, and you can use them to power up your burst moves, too.
That's cool.
But you get the ultimate, that's included with everything else.
Also, I looked at a couple of other games, and I can't believe I forgot about these ones. I feel embarrassed. Celeste?
Oh, of course. Oh, that was really good. I don't care if it went out for the extra game stuff. The main game was fine. It was good. It's just, it's a big test of patience.
It's a raw platformer in the best way possible. Ooh,
yeah.
Also,
it's brutal, though.
Yeah. And there's also two other games. Maybe one less. Well, I still like it just because, you know, I needed a game to fill the void, and it filled it pretty well. Bug Fables.
Oh, yeah, I played that when it was on Game Pass, when it went off. I just never got the urge to go back into it. I also liked the desert chapter, I think.
Yeah.
When I stopped.
I liked it.
Nothing really roped me in at that point. I guess it probably gets better later on. The characters seem like they were good, but nothing really, like, instantly hooked me, is all I'm saying.
Yeah, I guess I will say
this. I didn't see it, though.
I guess I say this, just from the game mechanically speaking, I liked it enough to see it through.
The game mechanics were good. I play on hard mode, so it was kind of jarring how brutal it was.
Yeah, so like that game
the
just
bosses, Jesus.
Like that's the thing about Bug Fables. Like just mechanically alone, I enjoy it.
Uh huh. Yeah.
But like in terms of just the game overall, like Sea of Stars is beating that by country miles. But there's other indie games I've also beaten as well that are in my finish category. One is Chained Echoes. That's
another good one, yep. That's another RPG, yep.
Yeah, between the two of them, between the RPGs I played in the indie scene, Sea of Stars is definitely the best in my opinion, but Chained Echoes and Bug Fables are both mechanically sound. They're both amazing. Ooh, another one that I have in my finish category, EX Zodiac.
EX Zodiac, I feel like I've heard of that one.
Spiritual successor.
Huh.
The game's basically a Star Fox spiritual successor in a way.
Ooh. It's always nice to have shooters like that.
Yeah. Nice rail shooter.
Yeah. I feel like I don't Yeah, I feel like I haven't seen too many of those.
Yeah, you don't
think
about rail shooters nowadays, it feels, for the names in any of the
It's definitely an old school arcade like genre, so I can kind of see why it's not too big nowadays.
I see Guacamelee's on here as well.
Well, Guacamelee's a decent Metroidvania style platformer.
I beat them both. It's good, I say.
Yeah,
it's definitely not one of my favorite ones, but it's good.
It's fine.
It's fine for what it needs to be.
Yeah.
Did Ori and the Blind Forest count?
I wanted to say technically it does, but they just got a lot of funding with Microsoft to basically make it a lot bigger. Like, that's like a boundary for what you call an indie game. Similar to Dave the Diver in a way.
Yeah.
The Dave the Diver film is very indie-like, but it had funding from another publisher.
I've got two other weird ones I have on here. Panzer Paladin.
Okay, I heard that one.
And Steel Assault. I don't remember Steel Assault, but I tried going hard for the achievement, which is basically the only quite clear one. I never did finish that off. It was painful.
I also did try that game Horus, because I heard really good things about that. It's like some like British platformer. It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
I heard good things about it, but I never got deep into it enough. But apparently, its writing is pretty good too.
Speaking of indie games, it's not on this SD card, but another one is what is it? I think my brain's drawing a blank on it. And maybe it'll come back to me, but that required me to go out of my way to pull out the SD card for it.
Also potentially Mina the Hollower to look forward to for Yacht Club games as well.
Yeah. Because I bought a lot of games in a while, but I still need to go and check a lot of them out. Like, I have Katana Zero, I still need to peck out. Cyber Shadow.
Yeah, that was from one of the guys from Yacht Club games, I think. It was doing their own independent thing. Or it's like somebody else is doing their independent thing and Yacht Club Games like helped them out.
Oh yeah, there's another game, a couple of other 3D platformer indies that I found. One is Pseudo Regalia.
Okay, I heard that one.
Apparently had like ridiculous movement.
Okay, one I haven't played that I thought about wanting to play, Hat in Time.
Oh yeah, same here. And also this other one that I've also saw from the same employer, YouTuber I watched called Demon Turf.
Okay. I feel like I heard of that one.
It's another 3D platformer like. It's a little bit more cruder and chaotic in terms of how it plays out.
Yeah!
I also have all the Spork Electric Jester games on here. And 2 and 3 I'm interested in because they're more like 3D Sonic in a way.
Hades!
Yeah, Hades, that was the one.
Oh my god! I forgot Super Giant Games! Stardew Valley!
Yep.
Some of these games are so big you don't even think about the big indie games!
Yeah.
Cuphead.
Oh yeah, Cuphead, that's another big one, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, for some Undertale, it's an experience.
Oh yeah, for me, Blazing Chrome.
Oh yeah, Hotline Miami's indie, I didn't know that.
Oh yeah, it is, it's made by, by extension, when we talk about those games, my friend Pedro.
Right.
There's a lot.
Rocket League was technically indie. That's gotten so big though. Yeah. Dead Cells.
Yeah, Dead Cells.
That's another really big one.
20XX and 30XX for those who like that Roguevania.
Yeah,
Mega Man.
Roguelike Mega Man, yeah. There's a lot of amazing indie games. Yeah. We could talk about this forever. We should probably stop!
Yeah, we'll stop here.
Unless you felt like showing off the boss gauntlet, which we basically follow the bosses.
Yeah, we follow the bosses, and honestly.
Basically, do all the bosses, that little chamber thing, and off you get the ultra thing, combining all these things, including the thing that makes you take extra damage.
But yeah, so next time when we come back to my channel, I'll do whatever I see fit. Maybe I'll probably beat Freedom Planet.
That is an idea.
Alright, see you guys then.
Yep.
Later, people.